I knew I wanted to be a fashion designer since some of my earliest memories. I was taught how to sew by my grandmother, who was a master tailor. I think that something my mom really gave me was a gift to just be individual and be myself. If somebody says, no, you can't run as fast as the boys, I was trying to run as fast as the boys. If they said, you can't go to art school because you'll never make money, I went to art school and I made a lot of money. The technician left the room in the middle of the exam. She came back and she's explaining all of these features of what like a tumor looks like on ultrasound. And as I'm looking at the screen, I'm seeing these features present itself. The day before my 28th birthday, the doctor told me that I was diagnosed with breast cancer. Immediately after breast surgery, I just felt like I was a teenage girl all over again, trying to figure out like a new body because nothing ever fit me. Nothing ever made me feel pretty. I was like, well, just because it has to be a sports bra doesn't mean it can't be a sexy sports bra.
So I took that feeling, I took that knowledge, I took that experience, and I said, would I be crazy if I started designing bras for women with breast reconstruction? So I started designing intimates that we could all be proud of, that could fit our new bodies, that would be comfortable and would be beautiful, that we could feel sexy in. And that was really the driving force to starting Anna Ono.
Dana came to me interested in revision reconstruction. 10 years ago, she had bilateral skin-sparing mastectomies and a standard approach to breast reconstruction with implants, with subpectoral implants. Even though she had a great reconstruction and was happy with it, she knew that there were now newer options. She was looking for revision surgery, specifically focusing on the opportunity to convert her subpectoral implant to a prepectoral implant.
I first met Dr. Israeli as well as Dr. Bank at our 2018 New York Fashion Week show. We had nippleless implant reconstruction walking on the runway. We had flat chests. We really had everybody represented, and it was really a moment in time.
I had the pleasure of working with Dana on Project Restored. It was a multimedia breast reconstruction photography and sculpture project.
I'm in Reader's Digest out of all magazines with this beautiful, amazing photo from Dr. Bank and Dr. Israeli's project of Restored that was a part of them casting my body before I had had my revision surgery. And as a part of that, the photography of my mastectomy tattoo made its way into this article.
I think that she's really dedicated herself to the empowerment of women facing breast cancer through every aspect of her life, whether it's her professional life, through her advocacy, through her charitable work.
A woman came over with her daughter and her husband. And she was just really in a state of distress after her reconstruction. She was in the bathroom changing and she opened up the door and she was crying. And she just looked at me and she goes, this is the first time I felt beautiful since my surgery. I got a thank you note a week later. Her daughter said to her, Mommy, that's the first time I've seen you smile since you got diagnosed with breast cancer. And like that will be the thing that will make me emotional because we sacrifice so much. We go through so much and the people that love us see that. And it just, something small can make the world of difference, and that's what it means.